Alrighty. Now that we're out of that shrine, it's time for us to, well, I guess actually fast travel over to the Great Plateau Tower. Whoa! Okay, that's actually a pretty neat fast travel animation. Although I hope that doesn't have to happen too many times. I think at some point, it'd be nice if we didn't have to go through like a little 2 or 3 second vanishing thing to teleport away. Oh, look who's up here.
Well, you certainly took your time. Did you forget how to travel instantly?
No, I remember.
Now then, I wanted you to join me up here so you could use this as a vantage point to search for shrines.
Well, I see a tower, I see one shrine, I see two shrine. Where be three shrine? I think maybe over there. Actually, that's, I think, off the plateau. Some of these other ones might be off the plateau, too.
Did you know about the scope on your Sheikah slate?
I did.
Look through it and you can stick a pin anywhere you'd like to mark on the map.
Okay.
Ooh. The pins on your map serve as reference points for your travels. Just stick a pin anywhere you're interested.
How do you know?
Oh, just a few tricks I've picked up after many, many years in the wild. You may take my advice or leave it. Go ahead and take a look if you feel inclined to do so.
Alright. How do you know how to work a Sheikah slate if you've never really seen a bunch of them? I don't know. There's one over there. One over there. A tower over there. And a shrine pretty close by. Let's look at the map. Are they all on this plateau area? They actually are. Wow. Well, we can reach them. Is there anything behind us that I can reach at this time? I don't think so. You can see the edge of the area over here. Okay, but what about over in that direction? Anything in the forest that I haven't seen yet? That I can put my pink pin on? Pink-ish pin? Light red pin? I guess not. All right. Well, thank you for the advice.
Having trouble finding the shrines?
No.
Oh, if you still wish to acquire the paraglider, you must put in the effort. I will not simply give it away, you see.
Ugh, what a jerk. Alright, let's get down from here. If I had the paraglider, I could just jump off the tower. Which will be incredibly nice. It's like, oh, a place on the high ground? Boom! Paraglider. Never have to worry about dying at super far distances anyways. Unless it goes into a giant canyon. Then that's a different story. I still have no idea how to cook these. Do I just toss them together? Alright, what happens if we slap a butterfly, a lizard, and an apple? I don't know. Hot-footed frog, a quick frog that can be found hopping around near water. Cook it with monster parts to draw out its speed boost effect. Alright. I want to be able to go fast. But I still don't know how to- cook. Like, and mix things together. Hasn't been introduced yet. I know how to drop food on fire. That's about it. Is this always gonna be here to remind me that this is the last place I died? This big red X. RIP. Rest in peace, me. A monument to my sins, huh? Alright. Now, what is the closest one to me? I guess it would be over here. In the Eastern Abbey! Wow, that's good. I was gonna check that place out anyways at some point. Without even having to need a shrine. I wonder if these places will fill back up with enemies at some point. Skeletons are probably a definite, but I don't know about normal people. Or, well, not normal people, normal monsters. So far, nothing there. It's only been one night, but That could be a good sign. You clear one place of enemies, and they're gone. Forever. Except for the maybe re-deads or undeads. Ooh. Well, I mean, I might as well see if I can make this jump. Yeehaw! That was a little bit on the riskier side, because I could have ran out of stamina while swimming and, I don't know, drowned or something. But we're okay! More amber! Still don't know what it's used for, but whatever. So is it just cloudy? Oh. Cloud lighting! Cloud lighting! Cloud lighting! Yes, I like cloud lighting. Hello. Oh no. I was about to say, how do I get past that big old rock thing? Well, it doesn't matter for now. That's bad! What's going on? What? Oh no! Link! Ah! God damn it. I pressed X to jump backwards and to go away from the place, and I didn't realize that Link was holding on to a wall. Guardians. Their entire bodies are covered in armor, so low-powered weapons won't do any damage. It's best to avoid these foes until you have the right tools for the job. Okay. Good to know. I'll just, walk by them. So, how many of these actually activate? Only the one? Is it because it's guarding the way in? It looks like it. Okay. Hey, how you doing? Ooh, ancient spring. A spring used in ancient machinery. It is light and buoyant enough to float in water. And no matter how many times it's compressed, it never loses tension. Neato. Oh, Jesus. I was hoping maybe I could sneak by it. Despite being incredibly old, its build quality is leaping bounds beyond anything using current technology. So I can't use my magnet abilities against that ancient technology. Shame, but whatever. I guess the good news is I do have the ability to climb over things. That's gonna take some getting used to. So I don't even have to, like, face this guy head on. Fuck. But yes, friends! Can they face backwards? The answer is no. This one can't face backwards. That's pretty cute. I don't have the weapons to take it on, though. Look how much health it has. I think I would have to go through all of my, whoops. I have to go through all of my melee weapons just to take it out. I don't want to do that. Okay. Who knows? Maybe we'll find a bomb in here. Jabage Shrine. Jabage. Although, obviously, we can't expect every single shrine to reward us with something super amazing. Wooden objects and dry grass catch fire easily. Be careful around such things while holding a lit torch. Durability varies with every weapon. And I want to read a lot of these tips, but the fucking loading screen's actually a little fast. I guess I am going to get a new one. A new rune. To you who sets foot in the shrine, I am Jabage. In the name of the goddess of Helia, I offer this trial. Helia. We have voice acting in this game, just only in certain places. Sheikah Slate Act Authenticated, Distilling Rune. I'm gonna keep on messing up Hylia until we hear Zelda or someone say it out loud.
Our goddess Hylia. Helia. Ah.
Alright, what do we got? Bombs. A bomb that can be detonated remotely. The force of the blast can be used to damage monsters or destroy objects. There are both round and cube bombs, so use whichever fits the situation. Neat. I'm definitely curious as to what the purpose of a cube bomb is, but I guess a cube bomb means you don't have to worry about it rolling away. Yeah. And then there's a little cooldown there. Okay. Alright, we got bombs. Which should allow us to take out those guardians. I'm hyped. I wasn't expecting to get another rune so immediately.
Whoa, Traveler's Claymore. A basic two-handed sword often wielded by aspiring adventurers. Its immense weight can knock enemies' shields right out of their hands.
Well, I mean, while I'm here, if anyone wants to fight me...
Shut up!
That's different. Okay.
You hear that? Okay. It's just a platform. Well, I might as well put down one of these. And then blow it up from a distance. Just to be on the safe side. I don't know the radius of these bombs. It looks like it could have covered that entire bridge, honestly. Okay, this is a pretty open space. I see.
Well, sure, I'll oblige you.
We'll launch across the way and blow up those rocks. Fire in the hole! Nice. But what about over here? Can I launch myself? Alright! Fire in the hole! Yeehaw! Wow, that even hurt me. Nice! And it was just amber. Alright. Well, we are learning things here. They did a very good job introducing that to us. It was like, and then that ball just launched back and forth and back and forth. Why? So we could teach you, dear player, how to play our game. Jeez. Yep. Alright, nothing hidden behind there.
So, what was your name again?
I'm never gonna remember the names of these shrine dudes. They're just gonna be all over the place, and it seems like we only meet them once. Thanks for the bomb, though.
Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero.
Thank you.
In the name of the goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb.
Yay. Too bad I'm gonna have to give away four of them just to get a paraglider.
May the goddess smile upon you.
May the goddess smile upon you, too. Farewell. Well, at least it brings me out of there pretty much immediately. I don't have to go all the way back to the entrance of the shrine. I was gonna say spire for some reason. Alright, let's see. how these bombs hold up against the enemy. Hello, my friend. Here you go. I have an infinite number of these, so that's nice. I have to be careful, though. It looks like if you damage them, they automatically shoot to where they were shooting at. Or that they automatically shoot where they were aiming at. So that's bad. Maybe I'm not damaging it. Maybe it's just left over from when I hit it before. Yeah, all right, I give up. If it's gonna be super annoying to you to do anything to these guys, we'll hold our horses until later. I'm sure we'll find some way to deal with them. Do a lot of damage. For now, though, it seems like these bombs are only good against rocks and possibly enemies.
It's a good thing we have an enemy to test out on.
Oh, he has a buddy. Maybe another one too? No. Alright. Ha-ha! Surprise! We also found a better way to open up items. Or boxes for us. Kaboomo! Oh, that was overkill. Hold up. Alright! How not? I don't trust that. Was that-
Oh no! Oh shoot! Hold up!
I need to shoot fire arrows into him! Kablam! Burn the bees! Anyways, what I was gonna say is, I'm gonna try learning how to cook here, if possible. Ooh, nice. Coarser bee honey. Honey straight from the hive is chock full of nutrients. Cooking this into a meal unlocks the potential of these nutrients and provides a stamina recovery effect. Nice. Like that. I hope I really get into this whole cooking thing. Like, really learn it. Sit by the fire until morning. So sitting by the fire... It's just legitimately sitting by the fire. No mixing or cooking anything. Alright. Well, let's try... The problem I have is... If we open up my inventory... Let's take a... Spock Goblin Fang and a... Summer Wing Butterfly. Okay. If I put them together... They just cook on their own, and it just flies away. So... I do need something to mix them together. And I don't know... I mean, we've encountered a couple of things that I think we could possibly use, I just... don't know about everything else. Are those... mushrooms? Well... I'll climb around and get some mushrooms. Rushroom, a mushroom that can grow almost anywhere but prefers ceilings and sheer cliffs. Kick it before eating to temporarily increase your movement speed. Well, that sounds nice. It's a
movement speed buff without having to cook it into an elixir, which I have no idea how to do. Oh, I tried to grab it on the way down. Okay. Need to find me a pot. Need to find me a pot to cook in, because if I don't, I'll never learn. Is this a monster place? Hello? Oh. Stamella Shroom, a green mushroom that grows near trees in the forest. It's shock full of natural energy. Cook it to release its stamina restoration properties. The Old Man's Diary. Ooh.
On this desolate plateau, the only pleasure that brings me comfort is cooking. And today I outdid myself. Truly, I created the perfect dish. I call it spicy meat and seafood fry. This recipe not only restores health, but it also keeps me warm, even when I'm traveling in the snowy mountains. With this dish on my side, I no longer have need of that itchy warm doublet. I do not know how I allowed this to happen, but it seems I forgot to write down a very important recipe. I know it contained raw meat and spicy pepper. However, I simply cannot remember what else I used. My age is catching up to me. Sadly, on this lonely plateau, I have only my own knowledge and memory to rely on. Still, if I did find someone who knew the missing ingredients, I would happily reward them with my warm doublet. However, it seems like unlikely that such a miraculous mission will ever be fulfilled. Okay, spicy pepper. This pepper is exploding with spice. Cooking with it to create dishes that will raise your, cooking with it to create dishes that will raise your body temperature and help you withstand the cold. That sounded weird. Cook with it to create dishes. Ah, all right, we're good here. We got it. So if I cook his pepper, I get his doublet, which I don't know what a doublet is. Is it his bed? Do I get to keep his bed? I guess I could look up the word doublet. Doublet. Oh, it's armor. Okay. It's fancy looking armor. Look at this. Pot lid, the lid of a large soup pot. It smells vaguely of poultry broth. Yum! It can take quite a beating before breaking. Is that better than anything I have? Ah, crap, hold on. Okay, you know what? I don't know how to drop shields, so we'll just do it like this. There. Ah, I started burning it. Is that the old man? Or is that a old man? Oh, you little bastard! I tried to capture the bird. Didn't work. Either I'll have to sneak up on it a little bit more effectively, or I'll have to shoot them. Now that seems kind of violent. We'll see. Hey, there you go! It poofed into meat! Raw bird drumstick. This meat is tougher and chewier than standard steak. Tastes better cooked. Well, let's see if we can mix things up a little bit. Hello, friend.
Hiya! Hiya!
Hey!
Oh, fancy that, so I meet again.
What are you doing?
I thought this tree might this tree here might make some great good firewood. Mm. However, getting a tree to fall exactly where you want it to is quite an art. The trick is to turn your hips so that they face where you want the tree to land. So, I see you found my axe. Why not help me out and give it a few swings? I'm working up quite a sweat here, but these bones could use a break.
Alright. Use the axe. You're welcome!
Oh, I see you did my work for me. Wonderful. Go ahead and take some of that wood for yourself. Don't be shy now.
Wait, what? I can actually get something from here? Oh! Wood! A portable bundle of wood. You can use this to make a campfire if you have something to light it. Oh! So I can camp anywhere I want in the world as long as I have fire.
Thank you for helping with that tree. Now my work for the day is complete.
What are you doing? I'm heading home. I can't offer you much other than a solid roof and good company, but you're free to join me. If you need to take a rest, go ahead and use my bed. Unlike a fireside nap, sleeping in a proper bed should really rejuvenate you.
Oh. Well, I'm ready at full health, so I'm fine. So let's try something out. Let's see what happens if I throw items into this. Hold. And then the beetle. And then cook. Aww. Sweet! Mighty Elixir grants a low-level might effect, which strengthens your body and mind to boost your attack power with all weapons. Awesome! Check a meal's ingredients by selecting it from your inventory and then selecting recipe. Recipe. Okay. All right. We're learning. The question is, if I put in more of something, will its power increase? So if I say put in some of these together, maybe even a butterfly wing, do we get some kind of mixed effect? Or some kind of disgusting drop? Ugh. Dubious food. It's too gross to even look at. Bizarre smell issues forth from this heap. Eating it won't hurt you, though, probably. Or, eating it won't hurt you, though, probably. Okay, well, that was a waste. We'll do the obvious, then. If we combine just the base materials, we learn how to make the base elixirs. But they're low level, instead of being advanced.
Oh-ho! What is it? What are you doing? Maybe I'll just survive by the fire for a bit.
Well, okay. Let's read his diary again. On this desolate plate, I'm looking for the cooking. I call it spicy meat and seafood fry. This recipe not only restores health, but also keeps me warm, even when traveling in the mountains. He needs pepper, raw meat, and fish? I don't have any fish with me, unfortunately. Still, I can do other things.
What is it? What are you doing? The body mind isn't what it used to be. Recovering from a bout of hard work takes a while. If you're hungry, I have an empty pot you can use to cook yourself a meal. Got any tips? Simply open your inventory, grab hold of your ingredients, and toss them in. Try to consider how the ingredients will complement one another. You can even make it just to increase your stamina. It's all about being creative and trying different things.
Alright.
If you're moved by any wild culinary inspirations, feel free to cook yourself a meal using my pot over there.
I cook something.
Let's take a look what you cooked up there, shall we? They say failure is a stepping stone to success, right? Perhaps they're referring to your culinary shortcomings.
Ouch!
In case you were wondering, I know you were poking around in my diary. That said, if you do end up figuring out how to create that dish I wrote about, my warm doublet is all yours. If it's raw meat you're after, try hunting in the Forest of Spirits. You'll find it in the northern part of the plateau.
Alright. I mean, I do already have, like, raw poultry, but that might not completely count. Okay. Well, still, I can try combining a raw bird drumstick and a spicy pepper.
Spicy chicken leg.
Hey, spicy pepper steak grants low-level cold resistance. The meat has been cooked in crushed peppers to accent its natural taste. Holy crap! Grants low-level cold resistance. Well, if we ever run into snow or need 3 health, we have that. I cook something. Judge it for me.
Let's take a look at what you cooked up there, shall we?
They say failure is a stepping stone. Oh, come on. Hold on. It's because he keeps on seeing this. Eat. You can't recover any more hearts. Eat it anyways. Cook something. Look at this.
Let's take a look at what you got cooked up there, shall we? Not bad. Certainly not good, but not bad either. In case you're wondering,
I just wouldn't say my cooking is good. The spicy pepper steak is not good. Look at that. That looks so fancy. I can't cook you something like that in real life. Ah, well.
So he said that there's meat up in the Forest of Spirits. Fun. Oh, we'll head to that soon, but I want to climb up there. I don't think I can do it from out of this position, though.
Nope, this isn't what I needed.
Farewell!
Okay, maybe we can cut down a tree to get across! Ho ho ho! Okay, we lost the axe, but whatever. We'll just have to hope that I can use anything I can to get across places. Bye-bye!
Alright, killed your friend, sorry. Oh, whoops. Torch!
I don't think his friend's coming back. Who knows, maybe he survives the fall, gets nursed back up to health, and begins to change his life somehow. I doubt it, though. No. Yep. I want to take it.
Yep.
Then blow it out. Ooh. Greetings, little chest. Just fire arrows. I mean, I'll take it. I have no idea if fire arrows will ever be, like, a rare thing in the future, but whatever. So, I could attempt to climb, but I have a good feeling I will just die. I want to test something, though. Can I find, like, spots where I can just hold my ground? No, not that. Okay. We'll find a more natural way up. If we look at the map, there's gotta be something maybe over here. So let's fast travel.